let's have a look at what happens to this matrix right here, right? If everything is converging correctly, then what we expect to happen to this matrix is that this last entry right here ends up converging to the eigenvalue that is smallest in magnitude. All of these values end up converging to zeros. And all of these values by symmetry will also converge to zeros. Now, we're going to do an exercise that shows that if we have a block diagonal matrix that is, in this particular case, Hermitian, but actually that's a minor point, then the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of the two blocks on the diagonal can be computed separately and easily integrated into eigenvalues and eigenvectors of the whole matrix. What that means is that once these values become sufficiently small, then for practical purposes, the matrix is block diagonal. It's actually even simpler than that. We've just peeled off one entry at the end of the diagonal. And our algorithm can then, what is called, deflate. And we can continue our algorithm by focusing on this submatrix. And we can then pick our shift to always be the bottom right entry of that submatrix. And in that way, we will eventually deflate down to a 1x1 matrix, at which point we have found all of our eigenvalues and eigenvectors. Now, because while we are actually converging to this eigenvalue at a rate that is similar to the Rayleigh quotient iteration, which is very quick indeed, we are also applying the power method to the rest of the matrix. It is entirely possible that we are fortunate that along the way, somewhere, zeros appear in such a way that we can actually deflate into smaller subproblems that are still a little bit more substantial. And if that happens, that's just a happy additional benefit of the algorithm.